Hello everyone and welcome back to Let's Play The Witcher 3. So in the last session, well, we ended having informed the herbalist that his apprentice had been killed by wolves, when deep down we knew, didn't we? I had a sneaky suspicion, and thankfully I was right, so I don't have to strip naked for a video update. yes, his apprentice was in fact to be found in the hut in that village. I didn't, of course, explore, but I did do some research, and he was there. The wolves may well have killed him, but those two weirdos, who I jokingly said, oh, they're going to be cannibals. Well, they were. But anyway, why are we here? Because we are seeking a meeting with the Master Mirror, gone to Odim, who helped us on the ship when we were kidnapped by the Ophiri. We're supposed to meet him at midnight beneath the willows. So, we shall meditate, pass some time, and see what he has to say for himself.
I knew you'd come.
You a soothsayer?
It matters little who I am. Your escape, I made it possible. Previously, Yennefer, you found her thanks to me, so you feel you owe me.
Memento you gave me. Pretty effective reminder.
That is its purpose. Incidentally, I find it quite funny how even the most rotten scoundrels have this inner compunction to repay debts of gratitude. Humans, elves, dwarves, all races. You really must explain that to me one day. As for the here and now, tell me, how'd you manage with your theories?
Well, after a couple of attempts, we managed to get rid of the blighters.
You appeared out of nowhere. Disappeared just as mysteriously, summoned a storm. Let me guess, you're a mage.
Oh, please, no. I cannot stand spells. Childish hocus pocus. It's just not interesting. What I find fascinating are true tales, true human lives, like the one I shall tell you now. It's about a man, worse than most, a vulgar, despicable man with a heart of stone. A man who refuses to pay his debts.
Really think this will interest me? Any reason why?
He's wronged you.
Olgier,
as well.
I knew it.
His name is Olgierd von Everick.
How do you know we'd met, and that I'm not exactly thrilled with him now?
Please, Geralt. I knew the Ophiri had captured you. Was I not to know how this had come to pass? Olgierd von Everick did willfully and maliciously conspire to cause you to kill a man who might have been cured. Had I not intervened, you would have lost your head for this.
Do you know why he did it? Because he's a degenerate monster in human flesh who feeds on the pain and suffering of others.
Well, you clearly don't like him. What did he do to you?
He and I made a pact. A pact under which I called on my many talents and associates to give him what he desired. And now the time's come to pay. Yet, he shirks his obligation.
Need me to collect a debt? I'm not some hired muscle.
Muscle is not what this requires. It needs a soul intelligent and clever. An individual who fears no dare. Someone like you.
Pure flattery, that.
Of course it is. After all, I am a traveling merchant. But make no mistake, I've Many interesting wares on offer.
Wares like?
Surfeit. Abundance for the body and soul. You will lack neither food nor drink. As a witcher, you might desire weapons supreme. I can offer you those you've dreamt of. Your body, agile as never before. Your mind, faster than lightning. Romantic prowess to charm all womankind. But above all, I offer a great and true adventure. An experience like no other. The fate of only the chosen few.
Sure sounds generous. And all that for my help with one small matter. Won't want anything else from me?
Just one. Honesty.
What did you do for old Geard? Break him out of a cell too?
In some sense, yes. I remember that day quite well. It was a light drizzle, yet the cold tore right through you. Old Geard appeared at the break of dawn, gaunt as a rail. His shirt, moth-eaten, seemed to have naught but the sword at his side. It quite pained me to look at him. He asked for help, and help I gave. Made him a rich man, successful, esteemed. He is who he is today, thanks only to me. And yet afterwards, he turned his back, shunned me. Sends me off when I dare ask for payment. Even sicked his hounds on me once. He's thus left me no option but to invoke the terms of our pact. And that is where you come in.
Huh. How much does he owe you?
Gentlemen, don't discuss coin.
Need to know the details if you want me to get my hands dirty. How much? 1 million crowns? 2 million?
I'm no usurer to lend coin for interest. No. What Allgeard owes me is far more personal than shiny things that clink. As much as I regret it, I can say no more. I must respect his privacy.
Well, somehow I feel we cannot turn this quest down, no matter what we say, so I'll save my breath.
What about you? Call yourself a man of many talents? Can't you take care of this?
Therein lies the catch. Our pact states that before I can collect my due, I must yet fulfill 3 wishes for Von Everick. But I cannot fulfill them myself directly, making use instead of a proxy.
Mm-hmm. So what you need's a sucker.
What I need is an ally. And something tells me I shall find none better than you.
What do you expect me to do?
To start with, join me in paying Von Everick a visit. Then, well, then we shall improvise. I believe, however, that all will end well. And once it does, we 3 shall meet and thank one another for the voyage we shared.
Right. Specifics now. Thought Olgierd had 3 wishes, requests, whatever.
He does. He may ask 3 things of us. Yet, we won't know what they are until we see him.
All seems a little shady. Your help, your pact with Olgierd, his 3 requests.
Think it over. I agree you've no a priori reason to trust me. But, as it happens, I was in the right place at the right time to help you. And it's also the case that the same man has wronged us both. To my mind, those are reasons to work together.
To my mind, not so much.
Come with me to see Allgeard. You shall see he's a vile, dishonorable man who treats the lives of all folk like playthings, as he treated yours when he sent you to find the Frog Prince.
As I said, I really highly doubt we can deny. Turn our back and walk away, and what would be the purpose of the DLC otherwise? So, he has sent us to kill this Frog Prince. I didn't like his attitude, and the attitude of his men, his followers, when we paid him a visit. apart from the one that called us puzzle peepers, of course. But, well, go on then. At the very least, we can pay him a visit and see what he has to say for himself.
Fine. I'll go see Algeard with you, but no promises.
That is all I ask.
Now remove the damn mark.
Naturally. Just as soon as you complete your task. Go. You will not regret it. We shall meet there. I've a matter to attend to along the way.
Another debt to collect?
Perhaps.
I don't like him very much either. But he's a man of power. It's gotta be. Volunteers for the village watch. Unfortunately, we're rather busy. Okay, so we've got to go see Algeard. Once again, back at the Garin estate. Alright. We'll go see what he has to say for himself. Excuse me, Mr. Goose. All right.
Looks like rain.
Looks like rain, feels like rain. It's rain. What the heck has happened here?
Well, look who's here. The Witcher with the fists of steel. What's new? Got a growth on your platter there. You catch some kind of a fiery pox?
Could say so. Manor's burning, you noticed?
That? All right. You know how it is. Feast drags on with plenty of dancing, merrymaking, rough play. We got a bit carried away, truth be told.
Plain to see. Where's Algeard?
Damned if I know. Must be somewhere hereabouts.
No! Please! I beg you!
Shut your trap!
Let me go! Leave me be!
Shut it!
I ate with yous, drank with yous, fought beside yous, and you'd kill me now? I'm one of yous!
You might have been, but not no more you ain't.
What's he guilty of?
What the fuck's it to you? Not your concern, mate.
Tell you what's gonna happen now. I'll ask again, polite-like, and you'll answer just as politely.
And if I don't?
Then I'll get angry, stop talking, and slaughter you all like swine. So what'll it be? Am I gonna hear why you wanna take his head, or not?
Aren't you a thorny prick up the arse? Ataman said to kill him!
Got your answer. Happy? Now piss off. We've work to do.
Just because I don't like him, I'm gonna stick my beak into their affairs.
No, you don't. Let him go.
Oh, this is bloody rich. Can't plow and believe me ears. You switch your brains with your cock or something. Get your mutant witcher ass out of here.
Or I'll kill you!
Go ahead. Try.
Whoa. What the bloody hell's this? Geralt, have you decided to play defender of the downtrodden?
More like gutter of sons of bitches.
Long as I'm here, you'll gut no one.
That a challenge?
Huh?
Why not? I've not fought a witcher before. Defeat me, and I shall let him go. Stand aside.
Oh, wow. Let's hope we don't lose, then. I'll make it fair. No potions.
Would you wait, sir, for the dribble to subside?
No oils.
Makes no difference to me.
Just the same.
Just plain
stunt.
Deal. Come on, then.
How long are you going to make me wait?
Okay. Maybe I'll use signs. He's quite tough. What? Well, he's got some sort of magical power, so... Holy moly. Firework? What the hell? Ooh! Little salt in the eye trick. My dog came galloping through my bedroom door, giving me an absolute heart attack. Why is he not getting... We're not doing much damage to him here. Am I missing a trick here? Why is it taking... I'm missing something here. Damn it.
Shut up. Oh, not good.
Oh.
Come on, come closer.
nice. Oh! Just gotta keep countering him, I think. Whoa, that was quick. Not very effective. If we counter when he does that big red maneuver, he gets tired. We can get a few chops in then. There. Barely. There we go. Damn it. Bravo, Geralt. Force me to strive. Oh, they finally hit me with his little trick. A back attack on him, that could be worth more. God, this is a good fight. I like this. Ah. Come on, Maverick. Getting desperate. Uh-oh. Come on.
That's enough.
Yes! Immortality.
Well struck, Witcher. You win.
But perhaps you'd care to tell me why you meddled in a matter not yours.
Wanted to prevent further bloodshed.
Well, well. The Witcher with the heart of gold. Unsavory as it seems, there is a silver line. At least you now know I don't easily lose my head. Release him.
Getting off cheap, mate.
Really necessary, that whole show?
Ah, show? Come now. A man must display some madness from time to time. Helps him feel alive. Dare say you know what I mean, judging by the mark on your face.
You're immortal?
Depends on your understanding of the term. Indeed, I cannot be killed. But it's not at all what folk imagine. Not dying does not mean eternally living your life to the full.
So it's a curse?
A curse? No, wouldn't call it that. I'll put it this way. You must be careful what you wish for, lest your wish be granted. For there are consequences.
Not sure I follow.
You know very little could hurt you. So you take wild risks. Chase extreme sensations. There comes a point you've done it all, and all seems boring and monotonous. The trick's to plough through that moment. Go further. Reach beyond what's known as possible.
Know what this is?
I cannot be certain, but I've my suspicions. That's a dangerous man you've chosen to deal with, Witcher.
Killed the beast in the sewers.
Congratulations are in order then. Your reward. You're also welcome to take what you wish from the manor house. If anything's left uncharred, that is. Was it a tough fight?
I sliced its gut open, and it turned into a man. You know that would happen?
Of course he did. He'd never have dragged you into this elsewise.
Gaunter old dear. Come to cast aspersions?
No. I've come to collect a debt.
You know you first must...
Grant you three requests, by proxy. I present to you my champion, Geralt of Rivia.
Champion.
That true? You know the Toad was a cursed prince?
He didn't just know. He brought about the curse himself. Did he not mention that bit? Well then, allow me to tell it. Quite the gripping story. Olgierd once loved a beautiful maiden named Iris. Yet, her parents chose to offer her hand to the Crown Prince of Ophir. Olgierd grew to hate the poor sot. At first, he wished to kill him. Then decided this would be too simple. So, instead, he condemned the prince to a base life in a toad's bloated corpus. Yet he grew bored of watching him suffer and decided to end it. By your hand.
Remind me, Odin. Who is to fulfill my last three requests?
My assistant, Geralt.
Then be gone. I don't wish to look at your face any longer than I must.
God, we're a pawn in the middle of some extravagant game, it looks like here.
Come.
Where to?
The stables. My men are preparing to depart.
Don't know which one of them to trust, to be honest. Neither. Yeah. So it does seem like a bit of a private spat.
This thing between you and Master Mirror, your quarrel, really rather not get involved.
You already are, I fear. He did something for you. Now you've a debt to repay. Am I right?
Yes.
Well, then you'll not free yourself of him until you've paid it back. But never worry. I shall devise tasks so impossible you will never complete them. Not if you go mad trying. But try your best. And your debt shall be absolved, while I shall live in peace until Master Mirror finds another aide-de-camp.
What he said about the prince, that true? You turn him into a toad?
Perhaps. Or perhaps the Ephiri Dauphin ate something that disagreed with him. You never know with their cuisine.
Never heard of food that turns men into monsters.
Then perhaps it was something he drank. I cast the curse. Revenge for a deep disappointment. I was another man then. Let rage get the better of me and hollered the words without ever thinking they could possibly come true.
Well, don't think he'd give two cahoots if he did.
Guess I gotta pop the question directly. What do I need to do for you?
Let me think. We're currently without a roof over our heads. Perhaps we should start with that. Bring me the house of Maximilian Bosodi.
His house?
So surprised. But why? I must live somewhere, mustn't I? What's the meaning of this? Second leave of your senses? You mean to mount a filthy horse? Out of my sight, wretch! Know what Vladimir would do to you if he saw?
Aye.
Vladimir.
My brother. There were times he himself stank like foot wrappings 3 days old, but his mount always looked fit for a parade. Oh, none rivaled Vladimir at feasting, carousing. Sadly, he's been celebrating less of late. You must find him and show him the time of his life. My second request.
Fine. Seems easy enough. And the third?
Complete those two. Then we shall speak of the third.
Once I'm done with those two, where will I find you?
I cannot know, as my band has planned some diversions. But let us say at the Alchemy Inn, in Oxenfurt.
Fine. See you there.
Ooh-hoo-hoo! Two tasks to carry out.
Shouldn't be too hard. But the house? How am I supposed to bring him a house?
Actually, the opposite. I wouldn't worry about the house. The brother will be the tough bit.
You waited for me. Nice of you.
I could hardly abandon my proxy to the whims of fate.
Thought I have to fulfill Olgierd's wishes myself.
So states the contract. Yet, nowhere does it forbid me from providing help. And something tells me you'll need quite a bit to complete the first two tasks.
Olgierd's brother. Why do you think he'll be tough?
I'm afraid he's dead.
Oh, dear.
Has been for years.
Never agreed to necromancy.
Necromancy is hardly your only option for reviving a soul. An old-fashioned ritual, a blood summoning. That's what you need.
That's like choosing between pestilence and the plague. Besides, I'd need the blood of the summoned.
Blood? True. Of the summoned? Not necessarily. Here.
Where do you get this?
Geralt, aren't you the curious one? Assume it to be Von Everick blood and get on with it.
Where'll I find this Vladimir?
Geralt, I cannot do everything for you. Use your head. The Von Evericks are well known in these parts. You must have met someone who's heard of the family. The charming redhead, for instance. The medic. You know the one.
Shani. Okay. And we have seen their estate as well. I wonder if there's a graveyard in there or something. And the house?
Borsodi's house. No idea how I'm supposed to bring him that.
The only Borsodi I know of around here runs an auction house in Oxenfurt.
Heard of it. My swords almost got auctioned off there once.
Huh?
Auction was held in Novigrad, though it was a while past.
They must have relocated. You just might get an opportunity to ask them why.
Fine, I'll go there. Then what?
How should I know? Perhaps you'll get inspired once you're there. Oh, and take plenty of coin. I have a feeling it could come in handy.
Guess it's high time I got to work.
A bit more enthusiasm, Witcher. You know, you just might enjoy yourself.
Yay, can't wait. Say I need help. Where'll I find you?
I shall find you. Good luck, Geralt.
Why, thank you, sir. Okay, so a couple of updates. And then we'll call it a day.
Damn it.
Dead Man's Party. How marvellous. Okay. First of all, okay, so we've got a couple of quests. Dead Man's Party, relating to Von Everick's dead brother. And Open Sesame. Requires us to go to the Borsodi Auction House. See if we can sort something out. So we'll get cracking with those pretty much at the start of the next session. Vladimir Von Everick. Been dead for years. Oh, apparently they do have a family crypt somewhere. Probably in the estate we saw that was locked. Yeah, I reckon so. Anything else? No. Okay, that'll do us. And I don't know if you can hear it or not, because I will be editing out the most of the background noise of my recording, like I usually do. But there's a whirring sound coming from within my computer, and I was convinced it was actually my processor fan that was messing up again. But having thought about it and listened to it more closely, I actually think it's my graphics card fans that are making the sound. So, yeah, that could be a new issue to worry about. But anyway, I won't bore you with my technical problems. I'm going to end the session here. Join me next time, and we shall go search out Shani. See you soon.